Yeah, the game actually just let out, so fans here are very excited to get their home opener win. And while it wasn't a sellout, they say there's a lot to look forward to this season. It's a new year for White Sox fans and another home opener.
I've probably been here in the past, well, 5-6 years.
This is my 20th opening day in a row.
Yeah, this is 30-some years opening day.
And for the diehard fans, there are some diehard traditions.
We feed probably a good 200-300 people that we have here. And it's, you know, it's open to anybody that wants to eat.
Steaks, chops, sausage, Spam. I mean, that's the main thing. Everybody goes crazy over the Spam. It's just something, you know, they started doing, and every year that's the first thing. Everybody goes, where's the Spam?
The rain Thursday forced the team to reschedule the home opener to Friday, so that did mess with some people's plans.
You do run into some people who either take the day off. It's hard to take 2 days off, or groups that came in from out of town because they wanted to keep their streaks alive. So you have some things that like that that happen, but it didn't really impact us. The weather would have been much more of an impact.
And while it wasn't a sellout, White Sox management sold about 34,000 tickets for the first game at Guaranteed Rate Field.
Actually, it's better on a Friday because everyone likes to start the weekend off in the right way.
If I had to call off work again, I was going off work.
And White Sox fans say they're remaining cautiously optimistic for the new season.
Hopefully they will do better than they did last year. You never know. But we're Southsiders, so it's like we're here no matter what.
And while those traditions will continue for the home opener, one big change this year, no more tickets printed at home. You'll now have to access those tickets from your mobile device. Reporting live at Guaranteed Rate Field, Shannon.